primarily trying to deter me from using them. Again, just stick. Where does pocket pawn fall? What is pocket pawn worried about? So pocket pawn is, you know, primarily worried about Indian possession material. And having been at the receiving end of the dismemberment from India in 1971, which I'll talk about, Pakistan has operationalized the posture that is very aggressive, very oriented towards battlefield nuclear weapons against Indian conventional forces that might cross the international border. And so they have a first use, I call it asymmetric escalation doctrine. They rent to escalate a conventional conflict in nuclear very quickly because earlier than, you know, India would, before any other nuclear weapons were used, because they're worried about the conventional nuclear war against them. Pakistan actually started its nuclear program before India tested the so-called PNA in 1972, because on the heels of the 1970s, I'll talk about this actually. So India's security environment historically, right, so it has the 1962 war with China, in which its conventional performance shocked even the Indian army and the Indian leadership. The Chinese performed so much better than the Indians in the 62 war, and India decisively lost the 62 war. 2 years later, China tested its nuclear weapon, right? So, Indian military program gets its motivation initially from its experiences in 62 and 64 with China. And to avoid nuclear coercion in the future against China, India hedges under the Nehru years and under subsequent leadership under Indira Gandhi. It does also have these persistent wars with Pakistan, but it has conventional superiority. And there was really never any talk about needing nuclear weapons to deter the Pakistanis. So India had a civilian nuclear program, right? It got a candy reactor stand there. Some of the heavy water was supplied by the United States. 54 reprocessing facility, 64. And then in 1974, Indira Gandhi authorizes what's known at the time under the Atoms for Peace program, there was a category known as a peaceful nuclear explosion, which was, I mean, there were legitimate uses, it was believed at the time, for nuclear, like you need to clear large swaths of land for dams, for example, right? And India had some technical uses for this, but didn't really fool it. I mean, a peaceful nuclear explosion, still a nuclear explosion. It wasn't, however, a warhead, right? I mean, this thing was a rickety, I think it was 8 meters in diameter device. I mean, it was hulking, unstable, rickety fission device that they tested in 1970. It wasn't suitable for a military program, right? It wasn't miniaturized. It didn't have, it wasn't even suitable for delivery by aircraft. It had to throw it out the back of a cargo plane, right? I mean, it still gave them certainly the physics of being able to sustain a fission, and have spherical compression. All of that was, it was a plutonium device, so it wasn't trivial, but it wasn't a nuclear weapon in the sense of that we think of. So a lot of work was still yet to be done after 1974, but it demonstrated the Indian scientists had the ability to at least, design rudimentary nuclear weapons. And there's several explanations for why it tested in 1974. The general security environment, I talked about China, persistent wars with Pakistan. It just won the 1971 war with Pakistan, which split Pakistan in two. I'll talk about that. That was the real motivation for the Pakistani program. But the real explanation is a combination of domestic politics and the power of the scientists in India. So Indira Gandhi was facing a potential series of losses in state government. She wanted a big win. There were several very prominent Indian physicists and engineers promised a big boost in her electoral fortunes if she tested a nuclear weapon, and they really wanted to test a nuclear weapon because they've been working on it, scientists like to test things to work on. And they have been doing this persistently for several years, and she then found her opportunity in 1974 when, right before a series of state elections, she authorized the test. Empirically, the test didn't actually help her that much electorally, but there was a belief that it might, and so that was some of the motivation for the test. So from 1974 until about 1989, for about 15 years, India's nuclear program went into effective dormancy. There was no high-level authorization from Indira Gandhi or her her son, who later became prime minister after the assassination in 1984. Thank you.